Well, a Conway woman has drawn plenty of praise after she offered help to non-black foster parents who work with the natural hair of the kids who come their way. It's opened up a conversation about much more than hair. THP11's Jay Jackson brings us more of that conversation.
Becoming a foster parent already comes with its set of challenges. One being if you're fostering a black or biracial child with a different hair texture. Learning how to take care of that hair texture is important. And that's why this Conway woman is making sure she is there to assist.
You feel great when your hair is done. That's with anybody. And to get into the adoption agencies and the foster care, these people know nothing, you know, especially if they're going to adopt a biracial child, they don't know where to begin.
Nikita Dixon is a licensed cosmetologist. She posted on Facebook offering to help any foster parents with natural hair children.
Hair care services, at home care services, what to use, where to start at with your hair, what to do, what not to do.
Brandy Fowler is a mother of three adopted biracial daughters. She also works for The Call, a faith-based organization assisting foster parents. She says understanding natural hair has been a long journey.
And my husband comes in the kitchen and he's like, you have to wash your hair. And I try to explain to him, honey, her hair is not like your hair. She does not have to wash it every single night.
She says she's learned through research how to take care of their natural curls and why it's important.
African-American hair, that is part of y'all's heritage. And y'all take pride in that. And Caucasian people, that is not something, like, of course we love our hair, but it is nothing like the pride that African Americans take in their hair.
We don't do that much right now because he's 9 months old, but as he grows older, this is going to become more and more essential.
Megan Hurt also works for The Call and is fostering an African American son. She's coordinating the lessons to be taught by Dixon.
But also just, you know, build confidence and self-esteem.
What better way of teaching them now, teaching the parents now, they'll learn later, pick it up, and they can carry it on into their adulthood.
Jay Jackson, THV 11 News.